The FreeSonus Fat Channel XT is a channel strip which offers a nice choice of different compression and EQ models. In this video, an overview of this channel strip. Hi, I'm Marlon. The FreeSonus Fat Channel XT is free with any purchase on Plugin Boutique this month. Use the link in the description below. So, the plugin is a channel strip with a semi-fixed order of processors. Two of them, the compressor and EQ, can be switched in the chain. First, you have a high-pass filter and gate processor. Then there's a compressor, and you can choose of three variations. The third processor is an EQ which also offers three variations. And to round it off, you have a limiter. All of these modules can be turned on and off, so you don't need to use all processors. The high-pass filter is always on. Turning it fully down won't have any influence on the sound. The gate thus gating and expanding. And offers a nice key filter to make tracking more accurate. With key listen, you can check on the frequency you set with the key filter. When you use the expander to bring out, for instance, the attack of a drum kit, it is nice to control those louder transients with the compressor. And there are three variations. The standard one is a normal all-purpose compressor with the usual set of compressor controls. It also offers auto attack and release settings and a soft knee compressor switch. Now, the other two compressor models are based on very famous analog compressors. The Tube Comp is obviously modeled after an LA2A, which is a tube compressor. It doesn't have a very fast attack and release times, and it will behave differently based on the amount of input gain. This plugin can switch between compression and limiting. In compression, it will compress between a ratio of 1 to 1 to 10 to 1. In limiting, from 10 to 1 to 20 to 1. The third compressor is a plug-in version of the 1176 peak limiting compressor. This fat compressor can have very fast attack settings. And the input gain also affects the sound. It's used on all sorts of audio. For vocal, it's used a lot, for instance. This type of compressor is known for its all buttons in compression mode, the nuke mode. You can set that here with the all button, and sounds great on, for instance, room mics. The EQ has three models as well. First is a 4-band EQ with graphical interface, which works as many others. The passive EQ is a Poltec passive EQ, which can do the cut boost trick in the low end, where you boost and cut at the same frequency, which adds a nice low end boost but also cleans up the audio above the frequency. It offers a high and low shelf, so it's more a finalizing EQ than suited for very precise EQ tweaks. These fixed EQ bands don't seem very flexible, but in practice these frequencies work really well. The third EQ, the vintage EQ, is based on the Neve 1073 style EQs, like so many which carry the name vintage. So it sounds analog, thick, and is generally a can't get a wrong setting type of larger than life EQ. This one also has a fixed frequency band selection and high and low shelf options as well. Now the compressor and EQ can be switched in the signal chain. So if you prefer EQ before compression or EQ after compression, this can be done. You don't have to use these compressors for peak limiting, for that you can use the limiter. Just dial in the amount of limiting and you're done. This is handy because there are a few things to keep in mind with this version of the plugin. For instance, not every compressor comes with an output gain control. The same goes for the EQ. So you need to be very aware of your gain staging to avoid clipping, which can happen quickly in this channel strip. And there's no dry wet mix control, there's no option for parallel processing. This plugin has these four modules, you cannot add more. If you want to use, for instance, two of its compressors, or its EQ before and after the compression, you need to load up two instances of this plugin. The plugin in the video displayed on screen will be an excellent companion to this plugin. Check it out. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell thingy and share this video and I will see you in the next one. Bye.